Hey everyone, welcome to a new Let's Play on this channel with my buddy Carl. Say hi, Carl. Today we're gonna be Let's Playing Starship Titanic. Point and click adventure game, last project of the venerable Douglas Adams. Very British and very silly and very funny, and let's get to it.
All right.
All right. You can see everything, can't you, Carl?
Oh, totally.
All right, if stuff's moving around, it's not just a still image.
It's moving around.
Sweet.
Oh, nice house.
For heaven's sake, get on with it. Oh, go on, don't just sit there.
Okay, Doug.
Oh, that was Doug himself.
Yes, it is. He's got a spot right there and at the end of the game. So let's see.
Oh, man.
I've got a computer here. Random cool. CDs? Nope. Random CDs do nothing. Let's try this one. And this is why you should only use blank CDs. Because a starship will crash into your house.
Or update your virus protection.
Yeah, that'd probably help too. Oh dear.
Tidy as you go. Tidy as you go. I'd forgotten what I was going to say. Oh yes. My name is Fintable. I am the Doorbot serving on this the maiden voyage of the Starship Titanic, the ship that cannot possibly go wrong. Now, as you can see, the ship, this thing you see behind me, well, we've had a little accident. Don't worry, no harm done, just a little scratch to the paintwork, I think. Luckily, your house was quite soft. I realize this is a bit of an imposition, but we need you urgently. Will you help?
And yes, he's the one who introduces us to the game.
Will you help? Hello? Oh, silly me. Oh, strange, deluded, benighted me. You'll need your personal electronic thing. We call it a pet. Here. Rather complicated, but I'm sure you'll figure it out. All you need to do now.
Yeah, he just straight up gives you the game interface.
You will help. And
just here you go. Now you can actually play the game. And yeah, what's really nice about this game is that it's got this text parser here, so you can actually ask questions, and they've got like Easter eggs and things.
I'm afraid we don't have time to footle around.
But of course, he's going to be impatient
all
right
need
now.
To do is type in yes.
No.
An odd way to spell it, but that will do fine. You won't regret it. Maybe you will, but let's get you on board anyway. Anything else you want to say or ask, just type. Not now, not now. We've got to get you on board.
Yeah, the intro is very... It doesn't actually let you do stuff.
A nice picture of the sky above your house. How nice. You should take that with you, you know.
And yes, the robots is broken. Okay.
Oh, dear, I can see you're new to having giant interstellar cruise liners crashing into your house. Here, let me show you. Good. The way this trip is going, it may be the last time you'll ever see that particular view. Come on.
That possibly can't be plot important.
Yeah, it possibly isn't an item that he just gives you that will help you solve the last puzzle in the game.
Oh, totally not.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's our maiden voyage, you see, but the ship has, well, it's lost its mind, and so has most of its crew, including me. Though I do have my lucid moments. I only wish I knew if this was one of them.
So I'm on a interstellar space cruise liner.
Bad to worse. I can't even find the buttons now.
Called the Starship Titanic.
Top button.
Nothing could go wrong.
It's my sell point settings, you see.
With
I don't suppose you do
deranged
see,
crazy robots. Anyway.
Sounds like a Tuesday to me.
Let's go!
Embarkation lobby.
All right.
Going up.
Human being, isn't it? Yes, well, of course, one's heard.
Now that's a view.
Thoughts. I just hope that you can sort out these problems, because none of us can. We're all robots, you see, and what's happened is that the ship's central intelligence has been lobotomized. Sabotaged, if you ask me.
You don't say!
We're all unable to function properly, and you may find that we're all a little doolally. I know that I am.
Oh,
so
no.
It's all going to be up to you. As soon as we reach the embarkation lobby, press the button on the plinth, and we'll be on our way. Then go and see Marcinta. She's the desk bot, and a bit of a dragon when her settings are wrong. She'll check you in. All I've managed to secure for you is a super galactic traveler class room, but I'm sure you'll manage. You can always ask Marcinta for an upgrade, but be ready to duck. You'll meet Craig, the bellbot, who should take you to your
I'm going
to
introduce you to all these characters without actually having them
then
on
once
screen.
You've settled in and made yourself comfortable,
oh, wow.
You'll be able to
well, I'm doing the same mouth loop over and over and over again.
All right. I love how they say you are the only one who can. What if I'm some janitor at a local library?
Here we are. I think we're about to take off again, but I'm sure
you know,
that
it's,
nobody's in control.
This game was originally supposed to have three endings, but you can't actually get the best ending in game.
If I can.
That sucks.
I hope you understand
the files are still there.
That for all our sakes.
Hmm. The only difference is that there's fireworks.
Good luck. Don't forget to press the button.
No, seriously, it's the only difference.
That's pretty
you can still get the bad ending, though. You start the bomb and then don't defuse it.
Shit.
Please do not ring this bell again.
Hey. Oh, I was about to say.
Not yet!
Oh, okay. Welcome to Starship Titanic. Please press the button for opening credits.
Oh, God. Amazing.
Okay. I think we'll see the opening credits now.
Okay.
Bing! Now that's a big ass starship.
Yeah. Looks like a mix between a submarine and Lost in Paradise Fifth Element.
Yeah, it's crazy art deco.
I like it.
Love the figurehead. Zoom.
Yeah.
And now the game's begun. You can tell because the lights are on. Sweet.
Oh, sweet.
Okay, there's Marcinta, but I'm going to try other things right now.
Oh, wow, that's creepy.
Oh, I don't feel well.
Ah, this is the succubus. In other words, it's the ship's delivery system.
Oh, man.
Don't feel well? Yeah, let's leave him to be sick.
I'll take that as a yes.
Yep. Okay, I wonder if we can just go forward. Oh, we have to check in. Oh, well.
Welcome, guest number, one, to the most glamorous galactic cruise ship experience in the whole of the space-time continuum, the Starship Titanic, the ship that cannot possibly go wrong. Ha! My name's Drubish. Marcinta Drubish. I am the desk bot. Do you have a reservation?
Well, do we?
I don't think we do.
I guess not.
I thought not. But I see that Fentible thinks we should take you on board. Ha, soft-hearted fool. I don't see that you're going to be any help. As far as I'm concerned, you're just a freeloader. Ah, well. Better get you checked in. What sort of breakfast would you like in the morning? Continental or the full porky?
Ooh, full porky sounds good.
Full porky it is.
All right.
Huh, good choice. Newspaper? The Baronton Bugle? The trumpet? Saxophone? Kazoo?
Ooh, I like kazoos.
Okay. How do you like your room? With a view?
Sure, why not?
Of course.
Okay. Corner or balcony?
Well, since corner. I'm the only There's one here. Place. Since I'm the only one here.
Hmm, good choice. Bed. Imperial? Royal? Presidential? Despotic?
The biggest one they got.
I would say that'd be royal.
All right.
King size? Queen size? Prince? Princess? Princess Plus?
Gotta go with Princess Plus.
Okay. Wonder what makes it plus.
Hmm, good choice. Fish?
Do we want fish?
Sure.
Thought so. Separate or en suite?
Okay.
Good. Doesn't really matter there.
Well, you certainly won't like the room you've got then. You've been assigned to Super Galactic Traveler Class, Elevator 1, Floor 38, Room 6. And don't come whining to me for upgrades, because you won't get one. Craig! Bellbot, to the embarkation
lobby. Oh, she was the bell.
Hi, yep. I'm Craig. I'm your bellbot today.
And hey, he's a lamp.
I see you're not carrying Craig. Any luggage. That's great. I can take a little time off right away.
Not Craig. Craig.
And see your Super Galactic Traveler Class. So I guess you can find your own way to your room. The door's over there. The elevator's around someplace. Relax. Stay cool. Enjoy.
Yep. Craig. One thing you'll notice is these little dials over here. They'll be important later. Once I get to second class.
We regret to announce that the ship is hurtling out of control through hyperspace. Any passengers with insurance queries, please refer to your ticket vendor.
So we're the only person?
Yep, everyone else is robots, but there is one other passenger that's not a robot. Want to meet him?
In this big friggin' ship.
You want to meet him?
Sure.
Here he is.
What? Call this a bleeding maiden voyage? More like a bleeding disaster if you ask me.
And yes, that's Terry Jones.
What do we hit now? Oh, bang! Oh, there we go again! Yep. Hit something else now, have we? What do you expect if a ship's got no brain?
Yeah, Douglas Adams didn't want to write the novel, and the producers wanted there to be a novel. So he asked Terry Jones to do it, and Terry Jones' one condition was that he write the novel naked. Yes, he's the parrot.
Pieces of 11! Questions? Questions? No point in talking to me! I'm just a parrot!
What is a parrot?
Questions? I don't do questions! I'm not some Bachman's warbler you can just interrogate!
Stop that!
Why don't you go and interrupt a snowy egret?
Why don't you?
What are you talking to me for? I'm not just some blue-footed booby you can stand and natter to. I'm not some blue-gray gnat catcher you can pass the time of day with. I'm a parrot. I'm a parrot. I got parrot stuff on my mind.
You know, as a bird owner, this is the most accurate thing ever.
Yep. And we got to take that. Thank you.
A stick.
Well, it's a perch. It's a spare parrot perch. Mm.
No, still a stick.
But yeah, you notice this room's a very unfinished.
You are entering parrot space. Ticket, please. Can you be my name, Buster? Missing you already? I don't think. Ha ha! Squawk!
Now, we can go down to our room, or we can check out the captain's chamber.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Let's to the go captain's to our chamber.
Okay.
Just.
So is there any other star-studded beat point?
There's a John Cleese cameo that he wasn't credited for.
Oh, awesome.
And that's where we're going now. But yeah, here's the here's the captain's chamber. And there's the captain, with her brain disassembled.
Oh.
And we gotta fix that. And that's the whole plot of the game, is we gotta fix that brain. Now let's see, let's find the John Cleese cameo. Nope, it's the other room. This is the room where we can look up the hidden stuff later. And it's also the room with the fuse box, but we don't have any of the fuses, so... it's gotta be this door. There we go. And there's a succubus. More books that we can't deal with. And, oh look! Push button to disarm bomb.
Oh, big red button.
The Mega Scuttler is now armed and preparing to explode. This
John Cleese!
Big explosion, so please stand back about 22 miles. Countdown commencing now. 1,999.
I've actually sat here at one point and waited, and he doesn't actually blow up the ship.
996. 995. 904.
All right, Carl?
900.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've actually sat here. It doesn't blow up the ship. But if you leave the bomb going, you get the bad ending.
91.
Wow.
990.
And you can. It's also really easy to make him start over. You just do this.
I don't like being touched. Thank you. Bothers me. Recommencing countdown. Now.
So how do you figure this out?
Well, he technically gives it away in one of his lines.
998. 997, 996, 995, 994, 993, 992. That'll keep you busy for a while, won't it? There are 23 274,146,401,881,973,762,031,616 combinations to try. So it's either that or get a life. What number had I got? Bother. Recommencing countdown. Now, 1,999. 998.
It couldn't be a bomb.
997.
It would be counting. It is a bomb. It's a bomb. It's a bomb. Does it work on ferrets? Does it save it works on ferrets?
994. 993.
Good old parrot.
992. Look at it this way. You can
he's gonna give it away.
All the combinations, which will probably take us neatly up to the heat death of the universe, or you can solve it by being clever. Which also won't do you any good, seeing as nobody likes a smart ass.
That's the password. Nobody likes a smart ass.
And run away. You still got how many seconds?
This should be a password for everything.
Oh, damn, I've lost count again. Recommencing countdown now. 1,000. 995. 996. 995. 994. 993. 992. 991. Well, that's me done. Closing down countdown sequence. Disarming. Have a nice life.
And you can do that as many times as you like. Just if you want to listen to John Cleese countdown.
How very British.
Yeah. Well, obviously... obviously, that's what you want to put on the bombs before they're disarmed. Because you can't disarm the bomb until it's armed.
Good point.
I love this effect that it's the artificial gravity and that it curves you all the way around.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
Okay, let's navigate to our room. It's elevator. We need elevator one. Which elevator is this? Elevator one! Sweet!
Hey, wow, you found it. So, do they explain who built this ship and why they made it?
In the novel, yeah.
Good day to you, sir, madam, or thing, and a great deal better than some of the days we've been having recently. Indeed, my old trouble has quite cleared up, so that it will be a pleasure to attend to your vertical transportation requirements.
Good old Liftbot. He's a war hero.
How?
Well, all of these robots had were people who had donated their personalities.
Oh.
And he's a war hero who lost his head in a war. Oops.
Oh.
Yeah, let's ask him about it.
Okay.
That sort of thing is down to successful intellectuals like yourself, sir.
Intellectuals, eh? And take me to my room. And he calls you Sa!
Awesome.
And down the elevator shaft we go.
Curved at one point.
Yep. Well, that's because once it gets down to the Super Galactic Traveler classrooms, it goes from having two shafts to one.
Hmm.
And because we're in Super Galactic Traveler's class, the rooms are all sort of bunked together. What room are we? Room 6. I think we're on ground floor, actually. Room 6. Yes.
Congratulations. You may have already won an upgrade. Please turn to channel 3 for details.
Okay.
All right.
A lot of people hate this puzzle. I figured it out pretty freaking easily. The reason is that everything in your room is remote controlled. So, I want this bed. Oh. Okay. Well, then that means I need something to put the bed on. That's fine. By the way, this room's so space-saving that they even included the toilet in it.
Huh.
And your comfy reclining chair. Or if you don't want your comfy reclining chair, you get your tiny little chair.
Oh, there's no TV.
Oh, there is a TV, but you need the bed out for it.
Oh.
Here's your sink. But yeah, the puzzle for this is reasonably not hard.
You then need a
table. And dresser, 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 dresser. Where's the dresser? There's the dresser. By the way, the desk fits into one drawer. See?
Awesome. So is this like a 3-bedroom apartment in Japan?
Yeah, thereabouts.
What are you trying to solve here?
Well, we gotta unfold the bed so that we can then lie down and watch TV.
Alright.
Now we gotta control the TV, which I believe is right here. Now the TV has a whole bunch of things. Let's see, channel 2. There's the pollen and the temperature in the arboretum.
Mm-hmm.
Super Galactic Traveler, this could be your lucky day! Yes, you may already have won an upgrade to second class and a whole new world of luxury. You may collect your complimentary in-flight magazine from the succubus in your SGT lobby. If the coupon on
page two
has lucky number 35279 on it,
well, I do have to watch this thing first.
You are just one step away from a travel experience most bipeds can only dream about. Take the magazine to the embarkation lobby, and our helpful desk staff will delight in upgrading you.
Okay, I'm gonna save that. Give me a moment. What's nice is that you can use... when you see things like this, you can save those sorts of locations.
Oh, cool.
The downside is it is upside down, so that is tricky.
Where is that?
Let's see. It's a first class room. Dink. Saved it.
Oh. That's genius.
Five. Floor 27. We can get back to that later.
That wasn't a blatant. Remember this!
No, we can get back to it later. Nothing's on any of these other channels, so... Fuck it. Now, however, I have forgotten to do something. I have to fix the succubus first. And here's the relaxation lounge for Super Galactic Traveler class.
Relaxing.
With two choices of music.
I like this one.
For emergency long stick smash glass. Aww. Remember that. That will be important later.
Don't have anything to smash the glass with yet?
Nope. We do have...
Morning.
No, I'll give it away.
Stop. I don't suppose you were ever... We're already there.
Sir!
Yes, sir. Top of the wheel it is.
Yeah, okay. When you get to second class, where the game really starts to open up, you can go to the observation deck,
mm-hmm.
and there's an emergency hammer dispensary there that is only activated if you poke it with a long stick.
From here, you can walk. Your requested destination.
Ow, brain.
Don't worry, that's why we took a parrot perch. But I forgot, we also need a parrot feather, so...
Oi! Unhand me, you!
Take the parrot!
You person! Stop it! I shall screech! I shall screech! Screech! Oh, screech! Don't say I didn't warn you! I'll pick you! Screech!
Yep.
But he gets away.
Cool.
But we've got a feather. So let's go fix the succubus system. Because that's why they all felt sick. And they won't help us till we fix it.
Let me see if we can figure out how we do this with the items we got.
Well,
This
is gonna... This would be one of those things that you'd have to normally ask the bellbot for hints. But I remember this.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I'm going to give you some of the backstory the game doesn't tell you.
Okay.
The ship was scuttled for the insurance money. And one of the creators of the ship... got thrown into the succubus system.
Feathers! Feathers make me sneeze!
So let's fix it by getting him out. And we've got our first chunk of the computer!
Yay! All right.
And we've got a fuse. Yay.
Embarkation lobby.
Okay. So which one is to the computer? The yellow thingy or the...
The yellow thingy. The blue thingy is a fuse.
The blue thingy is a fuse.
Yeah, we've got...
Remember that internet thingy is a science term.
Yeah. We've got Titania's olfactory sensor, which is her sense of smell. And we may as well set the fuse up before we go back to our room to get the magazine.
Oh man, that olfactory, man, that's so important for a ship.
Yeah, because the captain absolutely needs to smell things.
Oh, totally. Man, hey. That's creepy.
Yep. Here you go, Titania. Part of your brain.
We have three more pieces.
Yep. Now we go to the fuse box. Danger! Unbelievably high voltage! No user serviceable parts inside! You really shouldn't have opened the first inspection plate. This is not only fantastically dangerous, but you are voiding your warranty. Don't say you weren't warned!
Alright, we gotta stop here.
Okay. Okay, give me a moment.
Okay.
Do-do-do. And join us next time on Game Grumps.